Okay, this is part two of a two-part video where I am showing you how to create graphics in Canva that you can use in your video. So we're gonna be using ScreenFlow to edit the video. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go ahead and pull in all of the footage I need for the video and the graphics that we created in part one of how to create the graphics in Canva for your YouTube video. So let's go ahead and do that. Here are my graphics that I created, all PNG files, and I'm just gonna go ahead and drag and drop those right there. And as you can see, those are all the graphics we created in part one. Next up, I wanna go ahead and pull in the raw video files that I'm gonna be using in this video. So let's go ahead and pull those in. I have these two right here. Perfect. And now I'm just going to take these, drop these down into the timeline down here, put them like so. I'm just going to give myself a little more room here, make that just a teensy bit smaller, because whoa. Okay, so here we go. Step one is this graphic here, and I'm just going to go ahead and drag this down. And I'm going to just expand this to fill the frame. And I can also add, by clicking this little cog, a starting and ending transition if I want to give it some motion, because I created still graphics, not motion graphics. So let's just say we want a starting and ending transition. Let's just zoom in so we can take a look. All right, so I want it to come in there. All right, now if I want to change this to something else, there's a whole bunch of different options here. I'm going to try not to get cheesy with it. So let's just take a look at maybe a cross blur, see what that looks like. So that's what that would look like. Let's take a look at something, some other color drop. Oh, let's see, what's this? No, definitely not that. So let's just keep it simple with the cross dissolve. You can play around if you have other options in your editing software or you're using ScreenFlow. Check through the different options that are available and choose whatever is going to work for you. So I want to just extend that here. And for the sake of this demo, I'm not going to edit this entire video because there's a lot of other components that are going to be going into it. I just want to show you how I'm going to use these graphics. Remember, we created this graphic. You know, the four pillars, why, who, what, how. So if I want to like just have that kind of like hanging off into the corner, or you know, just put it here like that, and then again right clicking and adding the starting and ending transition, the cross dissolve, I can do something like that if I wanted to. And I'm able to just drag and drop these onto my timeline because I saved them as PNG files with transparent backgrounds. And I did that purposely, obviously, because I don't want a background to be interfering with the graphic that I created in Canva and want to pull over and lay on top of my video file. Okay, so let's just take a zoom out. Let's just scrub through this timeline. Step two right here is going to be this here. Again, I'm just going to just pull this in. Okay, so perfect. Let me just zoom in a little on this, add in my starting and ending transitions. Again, drag this out just a tiny bit, and then I want to go ahead and add in this eyeball that we created. I'm going to put the playhead over the eyeball so I can see what it's going to look like, and just want to make this a little bit bigger and add that in there. And then I want to make sure I add in an ending transition to fade it out. All right, perfect. Let's see, step four here, use your vision. I'm just going to go ahead again, adding the starting and ending transition. Perfect. And adding in this graphic here, adding in that ending transition. Putting the playhead over, making sure this is the right size and in the right location. Perfect. So let's just zoom out here. That's how you would then take those graphics that you created in Canva and lay them onto your videos. And you know, they're not motion graphics, they are still graphics, but you can add some motion in by adding, you know, different transitions depending on what you have available in whichever program you're editing in. So that is the quick and fast way to create graphics in Canva. If you missed part one, make sure to go back and check it out. If you like this video, make sure to like it and subscribe. And if you know somebody else who might enjoy this content, go ahead and share it up. And again, make sure you go back and check out part one where I show you how I created these graphics.